Here two spheres are given. Their surface mass density is same. Surface mass density means sigma. Sigma equal to mass upon 4 pi r square. This is same for each sphere, m by 4 pi r square. So here m equals to sigma into 4 pi r square. Sigma is same for both spheres. Now potential at the center of spherical cells, V equals to minus gm by r. We can take magnitude, so V magnitude is minus gm by r. Now gm is taken as sigma 4 pi r square, r is cancelled out, so sigma 4 pi r is potential. The ratio is given as 3:4. So V1 by V2 equals to, this ratio is given as R1 by R2, it is given as 3 by 4. So it is given as 3 by 4. V1 by V2 equal to 3 by 4. So R1 by R2 equals to 3 by 4. Now these two spheres collapse to each other and form a single sphere. So their mass remains constant. So total mass is M1 plus M2 equals to capital M. So sigma into 4 pi R1 square, because these are spherical cells, into sigma into 4 pi R2 square equals to sigma into 4 pi R square. So R square equals to R1 square plus R2 square. Then the ratio of potential of new cell to A. So V by V1. V by V1 is R by R1. R by R1 we have to find out. So let's suppose this R square upon R1 square we can find, then we take root of this. R square is R1 square plus R2 square by R1 square. Now we can take this root. So this is 1 plus R2 square by R1 square. 1 plus 4 by 3. So this is 25 by 9. So 5 by 3. 5 by 3. This is the ratio of potential of new cell to the cell A. This is the answer.